Hello everyone, so this is our second video in discrete mathematics. In my previous video I gave you some preliminaries about this paper, and in that we have discussed some relations, their definitions and a few examples. In today's video we are going to start this new topic, posets, and this is the short form of partially ordered sets. So in short we call them posets. So let us just start. Let us first take the definition of a poset. So what is a poset? A poset is a non-empty set P together with a binary relation R, and it satisfies certain conditions. So we have three conditions here: reflexivity, antisymmetry and transitivity. So we have already seen these three relations in the previous lecture. So let us see them again. So what do we have? We have a non-empty set P and a binary relation which is denoted by R on that set. Then we say that with respect to that relation, the set will form a partially ordered set if it satisfies these three properties. So first is reflexivity. Reflexivity means every element is related to itself. So here we are saying that A is related to A for all A belongs to P. Then second is antisymmetry. Antisymmetry means if A is related to B and B is related to A, then A is equal to B, where A and B are in P. So this is antisymmetry. And third is transitivity. In transitivity, we have if A related to B and B related to C, then A is related to C, where A, B, C are in P. So if the relation satisfies these three properties, then we say that relation is partial order relation, and the set on which the relation is defined is called partially ordered set or a poset or an ordered set. So they are different names for the same thing. Sometimes we also use this symbol less than equal to in place of R. We were denoting this relation by R, this R. But many times you will see this symbol less than equal to for representing the relation R. Comparable elements. So when do we say that the two elements are comparable? If A is less than equal to B, that means A and B are related. If A is less than equal to B, or we can say A and B are related with respect to this relation, whatever the relation is. Here we're denoting it by less than equal to. I can give it some other name also. It can be R or it can be rho, it can be anything. It is just the notation. So if A is less than equal to B, then we say that A and B are comparable. Next, this is the notation. How do we denote a poset? So if P is a poset under the relation less than equal to, then we denote the poset by this symbol, P less than equal to, or by this thing, bracket P less than equal to. Now let us see a few examples of partially ordered sets. So first is the set N of natural numbers under usual less than equal to. Usual less than equal to, the less than equal to which we just study in the usual mathematics, like A less than equal to B means the number A is in usual sense, in the obvious sense that we have, like 1 is less than 2, 2 is less than 3. So that usual less than equal to. So the set N of natural numbers under usual less than equal to, it forms a poset. You can easily verify the three properties here, that this usual less than equal to will satisfy the three relations: reflexivity, antisymmetry and transitivity. So every number, if you take any number, any natural number, then it is equal to itself. So this less than equal to thing will be satisfied. Then antisymmetry, if I am taking two numbers, two natural numbers, A is less than equal to B, B is less than equal to A, then that is possible only if A is equal to B. Then third, if I am taking three numbers, three natural numbers, A, B, C, and A is less than equal to B, B less than equal to C, then that will imply A is less than equal to C. Like for example, I can say that 5 is less than 7 and 7 is less than 9. Then 5 is obviously less than 9. So in the set of natural numbers, this usual less than equal to, it satisfies all those three properties. So this set N of natural numbers forms a partially ordered set with respect to this relation, usual less than equal to. Similarly, the set of integers, rationals and real numbers under usual less than equal to form posits. So in place of this set n of natural numbers, you can have integers, rationals, and real numbers. So they all of them will satisfy these three properties. Next, the set n of natural numbers under divisibility forms a poset. Here, so here, what will be the relation? The relation is divisibility. That means a and b are comparable if and only if a divides b. So when a is less than equal to b, implies that a divides b. So if I am taking that 2 is less than equal to 4 because 2 divides 4. So this relation is that. So here also you can easily verify the three properties. Every natural number divides itself, so reflexivity will hold. And then if n divides m and m divides n, then n and m must be equal. So antisymmetry will also hold. And thirdly, transitivity. If R divides S and S divides some other natural number T, then R should divide T. So transitivity will also hold. So this relation of divisibility, that is a partial order relation on the set of natural numbers. And hence the set of N of natural numbers is a partially ordered set with respect to this relation divisibility. Next we have this, let X be a non-empty set with three elements. Suppose I am having a set X with three elements A, B, and C, then its power set under the inclusion relation forms a poset. So power set of X will be a set of all the subsets of X. So if I am having three elements A, B, C in X, then power set of X will be 5, the empty set A, the set B, set with singleton C, then A, B, B, C, C, A, and A, B, C. So these eight elements will be there in the power set. So we are here, we are saying that that power set under inclusion relation. Inclusion relation means the contained in relation. That means two subsets are said to be comparable. A two subsets A and B are said to be comparable if A is contained in B. A is related to B if A is contained in B. So this power set under that relation, it forms a partially ordered set. Then there are a few more examples. Here we are saying that the set we are considering X, which we are saying that it is a partially ordered set with some relation. Then that X can be a algebraic structure also. For example, if I am talking about groups, then the set of all subgroups of G forms a poset under inclusion relation. So if you take all the subsets of a group G, and then define the relation. Suppose I am taking G is the group, and then H and K are two subgroups of G. Then I will say that H is less than equal to K if and only if H is contained in K. That inclusion relation is here. So you can easily verify the three properties here. Then next, this example is saying that a set of all normal subgroups of a group forms a poset under inclusion relation. So similarly, you can satisfy all the conditions here also. They are different examples. Here we are considering the set of all subgroups. Here I am taking the set of all normal subgroups. So these two, they are posets under inclusion relation. Third one, the set of all subspaces of a vector space V forms a poset under inclusion relation. And here the set of all subrings of a ring R forms a poset under inclusion relation. Then the set of all ideals of a ring R forms a poset under inclusion relation. So the here we are talking about groups, normal subgroups, subspaces, subrings, ideals. So if I am taking the set of all ideals or set of all subrings, set of all subspaces, if we are talking about the vector spaces, set of all normal subgroups, set of all subgroups, all they form partially ordered sets with respect to the relation, this inclusion relation. Now, next thing is totally ordered set, or in short, it is called TOSET. Like partially ordered set, we were saying that was, in short, that was POSET. This totally ordered set is TOSET. It is also called chain or linearly ordered set. So how do we define this TOSET? So if P is a POSET in which every two members are comparable, then it is called a TOSET or a chain. You take any two elements, they are comparable. You take any two elements A and B in P, then either A is less than equal to B or B is less than equal to A. They are comparable. Or we can say P is a chain if for all X, Y in P, either X is less than equal to Y or Y is less than equal to X. So that's why we are saying that it is totally ordered set. You take any two elements, they are related. So we are saying that it is chain, because when we will see the next thing, we are going to see that diagram, how to represent partially ordered set with the help of a diagram. Then if you are going to make that diagram of a totally ordered set, that will take the shape of a chain. That's why we are calling it chain. Next is anti-chain. Anti-chain means the ordered set P is an anti-chain if x is less than equal to y in P, only if x is equal to y. Clearly, with induced order, any subset of a chain, anti-chain, is a chain or anti-chain. So in anti-chain means no element is related to the other elements. So if I'm saying x and y, they are two elements, they are related if only if x is equal to y. We are not having two different elements there which are comparable. So in that, no element is comparable to the other element. That's why we are saying it is an anti-chain. Next is the covering relation. Suppose P is an ordered set and let x and y are two elements of this partially ordered set. Then we say x is covered by y, or we say y covers x. And in notations, we write it like this: x is covered by y. So here this symbol is like this, a little curved less than sign. Or this, for this, we are going to read it as x is covered by y, and it is read as y is covering x. So x is covered by y if x is less than y and x is it should be z. X is less than equal to z less than y implies z equal to x. Or we can say that there is no third element z between x and y. So we are saying x is covered by y if x in between x and y you are not having any third element. That's the covering relation. Before that, we were seeing the relation less than equal to x is related to y. If x is less than equal to y, from that, in the case of natural numbers, you can see that if I take under usual less than equal to, then 3 is less than 7. But between 3 and 7, you have other natural numbers also, 4, 5, 6. So in that case, we are not going to say that 7 is covering 3. But if I'm saying 6 is covered by 7, so that is true, because between 6 and 7, you are not having any other natural number. So 6 is covered by 7. So that covering relation we are defining here. So that relation comparability and this covering relation, they are different. So if P is finite and x is less than if P is finite, x is less than y, if and only if there exists a finite sequence of covering relations. We are saying x and y, they are comparable or they are related if and only if there exists a sequence of covering relations between x and y. You are having this x1, x2, xn minus 1 between x and y. Thus, in finite case, the order relation determines and is determined by the covering relation. For example, in the chain n of natural numbers, m is covered by n if and only if n is equal to m plus 1, like the example which I gave you just now. In R, there are no pairs x and y such that x is covered by y, because between any two real numbers, you are going to have infinite number of real numbers. So there are no pairs x and y such that x is covered by y in case of the set of real numbers. Now, this is very important, the diagrammatical representation of a poset, that is also called Hess diagram. So how to represent a poset with the help of a diagram? So for that, you should know the relation, what the relation is given in that poset. So let us just see these points. These are the rules how to make a diagram. So each poset can be represented by the help of a diagram. In this diagram, we represent each element by a small circle or dot. So whatever the elements are given in your partially ordered set, your poset, you are going to represent those elements by a small circle or dots. And any two comparable elements are joined by lines in such a way that if A is less than equal to B, then A lies below B in the diagram. If A is less than equal to B, that means A lies below B in that diagram. That means we are going to make some vertical lines there. So now, comparable elements, non-comparable elements are not joined. If two elements are non-comparable, they are not related, then we are not going to join them. Thus, there will not be any horizontal lines in the diagram of a poset. Same ordered set may have different diagrams also. The order is same, ordering is same, but they may have different diagrams. Like if I am making some diagram of a poset and for the same poset you are making a diagram, then the shape of the diagram may differ. But the basic that relation remains the same. Drawing is as much an art as a science, and as will become increasingly apparent as we proceed. Good diagrams can be a real asset to understanding and to theorem proving. So whenever you have a good diagram, a diagram in a good shape, then you can realize many important things from that diagram about that poset. So that diagram making is really an art. Now let us see this. P is a set with these four elements A, B, C, D, and this be an ordered set in which A is less than C, A is less than D, B less than C, and B less than D. So this relation less than is given between these elements. So whenever you have a poset with relation defined like this, the particular elements and the relation between them is defined, then that means you just understand that there is no other pair in the poset where you can define the relation. That means the poset is defined by these four statements only, these four inequalities. So this note, when we specify an ordered set by a set of inequalities in this way, like this, it is to be understood that no other pairs of distinct elements are comparable. So this is the all information that you have about the poset. So here you have four elements. So A, B, C, D, we are representing them by dots. And this A less than C is given, that means A will be below C because A and C are related, so there will be a line between A and C. Now A and D are also related, A is less than D, so A and D will be connected. Then B is less than C, so B and C will be connected. Next B is less than D, so B and D will also be connected. So this is one of the diagram for this poset. Now come to this, we can also draw this Hess diagram like this. So here also these four inequalities are being satisfied. Let us see, A is less than C. Look at this, A is less than C. Yes, it is satisfied here. Then A is less than D from here, B less than C from here, and B less than D from here. So it's up to you whether you make a diagram like this or like this. So that's why we are saying that a same ordered set can have different diagrams. Suppose you have this set X with four elements, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we have to draw the Hess diagram of power set of X under the relation divisibility. So this is not the divisibility relation. Actually, this is the inclusion relation. So let us see this. So for 1, 2, 3, 4, what will be the power set? Power set will be the empty set 5, and then singleton 1, 2, 3, 4, and then these ordered pairs 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4, 3, 4, and then take 3 at a time, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 4, 1, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, these subsets. And finally, you will have the set X 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are the elements of power set. Now we have to make the diagram of this poset. So phi, that empty set will be comparable with all the other elements because the relation is inclusion relation. So empty set phi is contained in every other subset of that power set. So phi will be here the lowest in the diagram, and then these 1, 2, 3, 4, phi is connected with 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the next level you have these two elements in a set, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. So see here, 1, 2 is connected with 1 and 2. This 1, 3 is connected, will be connected with 1 and 3. 1, 4 by 1 and 4. And 2, 3 by 2 and 3. 2, 4 by 2 and 4. 3, 4 by 3 and 4. Similarly here, 1, 2, 3 will be connected with all 1, 2, 3, as well as 1, 2, 1, 3 and 2, 3. Similarly here, this will be connected by 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 4, all, and 1, 2, 1, 4, 2, 4 also. So this is connected to 1, 2, here 1 4 and then this 2 4. So you must be wondering that it is not connected with 1 2 and 4. Actually, this is satisfied by the property of transitivity. If I'm saying that this 1 is related to 1, 2 and 1, 2 is related to 1, 2, 4, then by transitivity, 1 is automatically related to 1, 2, 4. So there is no need to just connecting it by 1, 2 and 4 again. They are connected by 1, 2 and 4. So similarly, for all these points, and in finally, all these points will be connected to this 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the Hedge diagram for a power set of a set of 4 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, under the inclusion relation. Now, let X be a non-empty set of different monetary values. So you have US or Canadian cents in that set. In other words, X is contained in, and that means you have the set of subset of natural numbers. Define the relation on X. Now we are going to define the relation on this set, which the set which is having these cents or the natural numbers. So in that set, we are saying that A and B, they are related. A is less than equal to B. If B can be obtained from A by adding A, possibly empty. So adding 0 is also possible, possibly empty. Collection of dimes or 10 cents and quarter, 25 cents. So I'm saying A is less than equal to B if B is obtained from A by adding 10 cents and 25 cents. And adding 0 is also possible, possibly empty, it is given. So let us see this example. For example, 25 is related to 35, but 25 is not related to 30. Why 25 is related to 35? Because 35 is obtained from 25 by adding 10 cents. But 25 is not related to 30 because you are getting 30 from 25 by adding 5 cents. So that condition is not here. So with respect to the relation which is defined here, according to that relation, they are not related. So this relation, the relation which is defined here, this relation is a partial order relation. You can prove those three conditions here for this relation: reflexivity, antisymmetry, and transitivity. So in this example, we are going to make Hedge diagram for this partially ordered set. So these are the values. So here you can see that 5 is related to 15. 15 is obtained from 5 by adding 10. Then see this, 15 is related to 40. So here, if I'm adding 25 and 15, you will get 40. And 30 is related to 40. By adding 10, you can get 40. So that condition is this, the relation which is given here. So this condition is satisfying this diagram. So with according to this relation, you can say that the diagram will be like this of that partially ordered set. So that partially ordered set has these elements: 5, 10, 20, 15, 30, 40, 25, and 35. And the diagram of this partially ordered set with respect to the relation which we have defined will be like this. So you can see that there are some elements which are not connected, like 10 and 30. They are not connected. They are not directly connected, but 10 is related to 20 and 20 is related to 30. So that from like this, it is connected. So now draw next example. Here we have to draw the Hedge diagram of factors of 120 under divisibility. So first of all, we have to write all the factors of 120. So factors of 120 will be 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 6, 10, 15, 8, 12, 20, 30, 24, 40, 60, and 120. These all will be the divisors of 120. So under divisibility, the relation is divisibility. A and B are comparable if A divides B. A is less than or equal to B if A divides B. So we have to make the Hedge diagram for this partially ordered set. So you can see here that 1 divides all the numbers. So 1 will be here connecting to all the other. Now here you can see that 2 is connected with 6 because 2 divides 6. 2 divides 4, 2 divides 10, so it is connected with 4, 6, 10. Here 3, 3 is connected with 6, 3 divides 6, then 3 divides 15, and 5 is connected with 10 and 15, so 5 divides 10 and 5 divides 15. So in this way, you have to make this diagram. So the relation is the thing which is you must know the relation under of that poset, otherwise you will not be able to make the diagram. And you just try to make a nice shape of that Hess diagram, then you will be able to give a lot of information from that diagram that you will see in next lectures. So what information we exactly talking about to read from the diagram. So let us see this next example. We have to draw the Hess diagram of power set of a set with three elements A, B, C. So in this diagram, here we were having four elements, but now this is a easier one. Here we are having three elements A, B, C. So for this, under the inclusion relation, relation is same. There also it was inclusion relation. So here also it is inclusion relation. We have to make the diagram of this poset of power set of this set under inclusion relation. So a set with three elements, then its subsets will be phi A, B, C, A, B, B, C, C, and A, B, C. So these eight elements will be there. So they will be connected like this. So phi will be here, the lowest point, and then A, phi is contained in A, phi is contained in B, phi is contained in C. Then this A, B, it will be connected with A and B, B, C will be connected with B and C, AC will be connected with A and C, and this ABC will be connected with all these three, because AB is a subset of ABC, BC is a subset of ABC, AC is also a subset of ABC. So this will be the shape of this partially ordered set. This is also called cube. So this is all about today's video. So here in this video, we have seen the definition of a partially ordered set, totally ordered set, then some examples of partially ordered sets, and then how to draw the diagram of a partially ordered set, the Hess diagram of that particular partially ordered set. So we have seen different examples of these Hess diagrams also. So hope you like it. In the next video, we are going to talk about order isomorphism, like whenever you have two partially ordered set, then when do we say that these two posets are isomorphic to each other? So then becomes this new concept, order isomorphism. Thank you.